when we started writing new music, we started thinking through these last couple of years. And my wife, she's a Christian marriage and family therapist. So she sees the mental health side of everything that's been going on. And they have a waiting list that's months long because of how much demand there is. Because we've all been through a lot, you know. And those families that had never spent that much time together, and that's causing issues. And marriages that, you know, the husband and wife had never been together that much. And so lots of, and, you know, people just isolation dealing with mental health stuff. And if there's one thing that she would say, she's like, when people work really hard at something, they can overcome anything with God. Like, God can turn any situation around, no matter what we've been through, or, like, it's amazing what people can overcome. And so we started thinking about, you know, all these things that, I don't know about you guys, but when we started getting out of this, I started kind of looking at my life and thinking through what I wanted to change, because it was kind of a time of, it was introspective, and I knew that there was things I wanted to change. I don't want this pattern to be a part of my future. I don't want to carry this thing that has been a struggle forever into the future anymore. And so we wrote a song that's kind of about leaving behind all those kinds of things, the things that weigh us down and drag us down. And I think the world tends to define us by a lot of negative things. You know, our struggles, our mistakes has become like our tags. And that's not how God sees us, you know. And we get defined by our past, you know, it can haunt us. But that's not how God sees us. We're defined by being loved by God and wanted by God, and we belong with God. We're children of God. And so we 2 Corinthians 5:17 was a scripture that really helped this song come to life. And it's where it says, when you belong to God, you're a new creation, and your old life is gone, your new life has begun. And I've seen that so many times in my family. I have a brother who was a meth addict for over 10 years. And I thought he was a lost cause. Just if you had told me he would get better, the amount of times he pushed away people that tried to help, I just thought, no, he's gone. And my mom was the one who always said, no, we just have to pray for him. He's coming back. And she really did believe that. And so we would pray and pray and pray. And he's on fire for Jesus now. Turned his whole life around. He's been clean for almost 15 years now.
Wow.
And he had lost everything. Even his kids were taken away by Child Protective Services. And now he has his family back. And super awesome to see. And then I have a sister who was, an archaeologist and became an atheist, which is kind of weird. Like, she lived in Israel. She wanted to be Indiana Jones, so she went to school for that. And when she moved to Israel to start practicing in the field, she got an amazing job working for this, like, one of the top biblical archaeologists in the whole world. And he is also an atheist. And started teaching her things like the Bible's fairy tales, and that the Exodus never happened, Moses wasn't a real person, Jesus wasn't a real person, like, just crazy stuff like that. And she started believing it. And she would come home and just debate with us, and it just broke my parents' hearts. And my dad, he passed away in 2004, but he gave his Bible, which was like his note Bible that he had all of his notes in and highlighted passages. And he gave it to my sister shortly before he died. And he said, please keep this. I know it doesn't mean anything to you, but just keep it. You know, that's my request. And he was praying that God would use it someday. And almost 10 years later, she was going through a really hard season with her family. And she and her husband were having, it was a real dark time for them. And my sister started having these dreams. And Jesus was showing up in the dreams. And she would call me, she was like, Jesus in my dreams, I don't like it. And I'm like, well, maybe you should pay attention to what he's saying. And one night the dream was so strong that she couldn't go back to sleep. And she got up to get some water, and as she's passing through her living room, she saw that Bible on the bookshelf. And for the first time since my dad gave it to her, almost a decade before, she went and opened it up. And then right there on one of the pages she opened to, there was a highlighted passage, and it just jumped off the pages at her and spoke to her. And it was exactly what she needed in that moment. And for the next two nights, she kept going back to that Bible, and she said each night there was scripture that would just come alive. And it was exactly what she needed in that moment. And she called me. It was the middle of the night for her. She called me and said, you're going to think I'm crazy, but I think Jesus is pursuing me. She said, I want to give my life to Jesus. So I prayed with her on the phone. And then 3 months later, she flew out to Arizona, where I live, and I got to baptize her.
awesome.
Yeah. So she's been on fire for Jesus ever since. Not only that, but her husband, who is an Israeli Sabra Jew, which means his family goes, like, they can trace their line back to Aaron, like, goes way back. And he became a Christian, so he's a Messianic Jew now.
Awesome.
And so they moved back to Israel last October and started a ministry there to reach out to the Jewish community and science, archaeology communities, and pretty awesome. So, but what that taught me was whatever situation you're in, whatever it is, God can change it, and God can bring people back. You know, prodigal children can come home. I've seen the addiction can be broken. I've seen God restore families. And whatever's in our past, it doesn't have to stay that way. So this song is really about the freedom that we have with the life that Jesus has for us. Mm-hmm. It's called Say Goodbye, Say Hello. It's not the Beatles song.
Say goodbye, say goodbye. Say goodbye, say goodbye. If your thoughts are like a storm and you can't stop the rain, if you're carrying your past like it's a ball and chain, if you feel like it won't get better, there's hope, don't you dare say never. Step out of the dark into a brand new day. Say goodbye, goodbye to the enemy's lies, goodbye to the fear inside.
Say goodbye,
goodbye to the shame you hide, goodbye to regret the life. Say hello to born again, say hello to love that never ends. So you can leave the past behind, look it straight in the eye. Say goodbye,
say goodbye, say goodbye.
Ocean, you can sail away. Untie the rope that's holding you to your mistakes. This freedom is sunny weather.